My name is Vanessa, and today I'm really excited to do the first of a series of money-saving eco tips. We all want to save money. We are budgeting, we're doing everything we possibly can, but I am here to tell you some really easy things that you can do, just little adjustments in your everyday life to help you save more money. Why not give it a try? What are you gonna lose? You're definitely gonna save some money, so it's worth a try. I promise that these are really easy, you don't need to buy anything extra, and you are going to be so happy with the extra money in your bank. So, let's get started. See my little laundry closet behind me here. When it comes to doing laundry, there's so many different things that you can do to save yourself money while being eco-friendly. One of the easiest things to do is switch to cold water. By switching to cold, you're going to save on average 6% off your bills, which could be as little as $30 a year, but goes up a lot from there depending on how much laundry you're doing. I do a lot of laundry, so this is one thing I'm definitely sure to do. And yes, your clothes will get clean. As long as you're using a good soap, you can use cold water and it works great. Another thing that you can do is switch to a biodegradable, good eco-friendly soap that is concentrated. This one here is BioVert. It's 2x concentrated. This huge thing here is 75 loads of laundry and it lasts me forever. You can tell here the cap here is super tiny. You just fill it up to there for a large load and everything comes out smelling delicious, like morning dew, and it works great with cold water. But definitely switch to a concentrated soap and cold water, and you're gonna see the extra dollars in your bank account just by making those two easy switches. Another great thing to do to save yourself money when you're doing laundry is by line drying whenever possible. You can line dry or get one of these guys like I have for inside. And not only does it save you money, but it also keeps your clothes lasting a lot longer because the heat of the dryer can be quite damaging. So this is going to save you money on energy, seeing as one load of laundry uses about 3.3 kilowatts of energy. So depending on how much you're line drying, you can save as much as 50 cents per load, but work that up over a year and you can save as much or as little as $85 a year. So that's pretty big. Not to mention the money you're saving on replacing clothing that is stretched out and lost its elasticity and shape because of putting it in the dryer. So this is a great tip to save yourself money and keep your clothes lasting longer. So each and every year I spend so much money on books, and often these books get read and then put in my bookshelf and never read again. So in order to save myself money and all of you guys, a very eco-friendly tip would be to go to the library. By renting the books instead of purchasing, you are going to save on average about $118 each year. That is huge. There's so many great things you can do with that extra money. Other options would be downloading on your iPad or iPod, whatever you might have, or your Kindle. That's a great option as well. But keep those trees where they belong in the forest, and really, really try to go to the library or download your books instead. It's definitely a goal I have for myself, and I'm really eager to try to save an extra $118 a year. So that's a good one on my list. My next money-saving eco tip is a really good one, and it's super simple, and more people are switching. This one is paperless billing. Each and every month, we get loads of mail, and it's so much wasted paper that should otherwise be used for better things. Often it doesn't get recycled, which just adds to the frustration and the waste. So one thing that you can do, switch to paperless billing. A lot of companies are now offering little rebates. So whether it be dollar off each bill or special promotions, whatever it may be, this is gonna save you money because not only does it save you the dollar or so off each bill, but also the stamps it takes to send them back, the envelopes, the time it takes to get to the post box, all of those different things. So it can save you as much as $70 a year just by switching to paperless billing. So it's something I suggest you give a try. I get all my bills sent to my email, and goodness am I ever thankful because I never forget to pay a bill. It reminds me, and I get to also check up on all my accounts. So it's a really great, eco-friendly, very convenient alternative to the standard paper billing. Give it a try, you might like it. So I love this next tip. We all have so many old electronics, cell phones that either don't work or we've moved on, upgraded, and what do you do with it? Sure, if they're broken, obviously save them out of the landfill and recycle them. There's a lot of great places that are taking broken old electronics or computers, and I suggest you contact your local city or township to find out where you can recycle old electronics. But what if they still work? Well, I found a website called nextworth.com. They send you money for your electronics. So I was a little blown away by this. So I logged on. Firstly, you type in what you have. They ask you questions like for a computer or for a phone, for instance. Is the screen cracked? Is it functioning? Can you turn it on? All of those things. So I filled out the form based on a few different things that I had. I tried my iPhone 4S for starters, and based on the fact that there is no cracked screen, it's fully functioning, the power works, all of that, they are willing to offer me $235. So my goodness, if you have an old phone, this is definitely a good place to go. Then I was thinking, I also have a BlackBerry that is completely broken, it will not turn on, and the screen is cracked. So I thought, that's gotta go in the garbage, right? They probably won't give me any money for that. But again, I was wrong. I sent in a quote or filled out the form, and based on the fact that it was completely broken with a cracked screen, they are willing to offer me $32 for it. And that is a whole lot better than just recycling it and having, you know, nothing. So why not get a little bit of your money back? You send it in for free and they examine it, and based on if it's what you said it was and in the condition you said, they'll send you a check. Awesome. Why not get some money out of these old phones that you no longer use? It's a really awesome money-saving eco tip. So whether it's line drying your clothes, switching to cold water, going to the library more often, or even selling your old electronics, I challenge you guys to try at least one of these things. See how easy it is to save yourself a little bit more money while being eco-friendly. And I assure you, it's super simple and your bank accounts will thank you. Thank you so much again for coming by Organic Please. I look forward to seeing you again soon. Take care.